Shambho, Shambho, Mahadevaya. Yoga, Yoga, Yogeshwaraya. Shambho, Shambho, Mahadevaya.
Bandhan Pramanar Doi Den Chara. Namaskaram. Namaskaram to everyone. Well, the spread of the virus and the fatalities or death it's causing, unfortunately, is picking up pace, particularly in the United States. I think the last 24 hours have been the worst. Over 2,000 people dead. The number who's tested positive has gone over 600,000. India also, over 380 deaths, but one, if you can call it encouraging sign, one encouraging sign is it is happening in small clusters. Mumbai, Pune, Indore and Delhi together accounting for over 60% of both reported cases and deaths. That gives us some, hopefully, some possibility we can contain it in small areas rather than spreading it across the country. But at the same time, at least one case has been reported in over 380 districts across the country. So, which way it'll fall? All depends on how responsibly every citizen acts in this country. Unfortunately, New York State is simply running away. Doesn't look like it can be managed within next week or 2 weeks. It looks like it's going to pick up more more pace. Definitely it'll pick up more pace in India. And of course, there is a severe lockdown till 20th of April. After that, a more relaxed lockdown till 3rd of May in this country. But how effective the lockdown is simply depends on how disciplined the citizens will be. Unfortunately, I see a lot of people taking pleasure in spreading fake news, creating confusion, reporting things which never happened. I don't know what. It's really pathetic that somebody can take pleasure in these kind of things when there's such immense suffering, both health-wise and financially, particularly for the poorer people in the country and in the world. If we don't handle this right, well, if it really takes a large segment of population, we would be probably pushing 150 to 200 million people back into poverty. We got them out in the last 15 years. We would be pushing them right back into poverty once again, below the poverty line, which is not a thing that we want to see. This is not something that anybody should take pleasure in playing mischief and causing confusion simply because you have social media tools in your hands. But unfortunately, it's a small number, but still it's painful to see that people take pleasure in such things when there is so much struggle. Particularly the medical professionals are going through enormous struggle. And today I spoke to the Punjab, the premier medical institution in Punjab, in Chandigarh. So all the doctors, their concerns, and the kind of decisions that they have to make. In Italy, when they had to make decisions as to who should… who's talking, please? When they had to make decisions in Italy as to who should get ventilators and who should not, they decided on the basis of age. That means, if you and your mother both were sick, you will choose that your mother will die. This is not a kind of decision that should ever come into the hands of any human being. Because if you make such a decision, you will have to live with it for the rest of your life. So unfortunately, doctors were forced to make such decisions. In some other countries, they put lots, a lottery, who will get the ventilator. There are 100 patients in the hospital, but only 5 ventilators, who will get the ventilator? Who will get to live, who will get to die? By lots. So, we should not push the nation, the world and the medical community and ourselves into that situation where you will have to take that kind of calls. On what basis will one live and what basis we will allow another person to die? This is not right. But if things go out of hand, that's how it will be. Those are the kind of decisions all of us may have to make. So let's not push ourselves there, it's very, very important. So as a part of raising funds for Beat the Virus campaign we are doing, the numbers that need basic nourishment and help, that number is increasing. We did not think in rural India there would be so many people, but the number of migrant workers, they're all coming together now because of this food offering that we are making. So the challenge of raising the funds and keeping it going, we do not know for how many months this will be needed. Because even if government relaxes the lockdown, for economic activity to get back into position, get back into full buzz, will take a certain amount of time, we do not know how much. So, as a part of this, we are putting up a painting for sale. It's not much of a painting, nor am I much of a painter. I'm just hoping, based on my other reputations, I will manage to sell the painting for a substantial amount, not because of the quality of the painting. We'll put it up now just for you to see, because many people have been asking questions. Can you read? A day is but a piece of time, a piece that lets us live and die. On this day, let us live and live totally. Don't insult me by asking Sadhguru, what is all this imagery going to mean? If you ask me that question, that means it's not making any sense to you. Let it be that way, it's abstract painting, so it's not supposed to make any sense. Because the image is large and you're not able to… I mean, image is not large enough for all of you to see. We will go part by part, somebody please decide in what order. Those of you who are suffering my painting long distance, please bear with me. the insect value has gone up in the world, I can understand that. So, probably in a couple of days, we will set up a platform before 30th of April. Whoever donates the maximum amount for Beat the Virus Fund, they will get the painting. And others, if they want, we will make copies of it. They can also have a smaller copy. This is… this painting is 5 by 5 in size, so before you buy it, you must see if you have a wall. It's 5 feet by 5 feet. Anyway, we'll leave it there, please. Questions?
This question is from Jay. Namaskaram Sadhguru. Couple of days back you spoke in Darshan that you or anyone can intervene post-death only if karmic shell has become really thin. But earlier you had mentioned that if one sits with you, there is no coming back for that person. I'm a little anxious. Are you going back on your promise?
Oh. Now, you're some kind of a disciple, whoever you are. Instead of telling me, Sadhguru, I will make it as thin as you want. I'll make it as thin as it is needed for you. Instead of that, you're asking me, Sadhguru, you promise then, will you stick to the promise or are you going back? This is the same position that Ananda Tirtha took. Well, this needs to be understood. See, the problem with people is they have taken their individual experience of life rather too seriously. They don't understand that this individual experience that you have of life is just sheer magnanimity of creation, that's all. There's nothing to it. They can just pull the plug anytime. See, right now the virus, you're gone. Today you're fine and tomorrow morning you may be gone. The entire world, nearly the entire world is under lockdown. Just an invisible virus. So you understand that's how fragile your individual existence is. At the same time, it is built in such a way that it can last and persist. Its persistence, how persistent this individual life is, simply depends upon how identified it is with its individual self. And the fundamental the structures which form an individual life. See, you are a… you as a life, you're essentially a life, then a body, then a little bit of mind. Out of this combination, you become a person. Because you become a person, you got a whole lot of stuff in the world. You have a home, you have a family, you have this, you have that, you even have a guru. Full. All the accessories you have, full on. But you need to understand you're essentially a piece of life. When it comes to body, we can say this is my body, that's your body. When it comes to the structure of our mind, I can say this is my mind, that's your mind. But when it comes to life, there is no such thing as my life and your life. It is one great phenomena of life happening. You can capture a little and claim it is mine, or you can continuously enhance the volume of life. You can only enhance it if you are not identified with the little that you have gathered. Little that you gathered is because of variety of parameters. Just by the privilege of birth, then with growth, some may grow, some may not grow. I'm saying as life, body grows, mind grows, activity grows, but did this life become more? Depends on many things. If you capture a little bit of life and get identified with that, you will just stay as that. You say you're a spiritual seeker. I also believed you as you believed me. When when I said, after you came and sat and you said, "Sadhguru, we're really seekers, we're genuine," then I said, if you sit with me, this is it for you. So are you going back on your promise that you're a seeker? If you are a seeker, that means you're always seeking. You're not just identified with what you have. If that is so, if this life keeps expanding, the karmic structure becomes thinner and thinner. If you really allow it to expand, it'll become flimsy. I said, if you make it very thin and flimsy, it'll be easy for me. But now you're holding me on my promise. Doesn't matter, Sadhguru, I'm thick as a ball, but you promised. I am not going on back on my promise. Let me explain the process to you. After that, you choose whether you want to be thick or thin. This question is coming because little thick here also, I think. Thick means strong, you know. The most popular, maybe popular is not the word, most prevalent nut in Isha Yoga Center is the groundnut. I took back the word popular, prevalent. So, a groundnut is not really a nut. It's a legume, it's not really a nut. But because it grows in the ground and it needs some protection, nature gave it a nice shell. Because it has a shell, it is pretending to be a nut, just like you. It's not really a nut, but acts like one. So, throughout your entire life, you can go about like a real nut, which most people manage to do. But what death means is, they crack the nut. Death is a nutcracker. So the shell is cracked, physical body and this mind has come apart. But you know, it has an inner layer of protection. You have seen that little papery, thin, another layer on the groundnut. It's called testa. This is very important. As long as this is there, though the outer shell is broken, once again it can become, it can sprout, become a plant, and again become one nut, will become many nuts. They say there were only two nuts, Adam and Eve. Look at you now. So, this one nut, if you leave that skin, it can sprout and become many nuts. Those many nuts again will go through the same process and become many, many nuts. So, what I promised you is that when the time comes, this thin layer, papery layer, I will skin it for you. If you are well soaked, simply easily we can remove. If you are not well soaked, I have to use my nails and do. If you want that, I will do. It hurts, that's all. If I forcefully remove a layer from you, it will hurt. But if you have soaked it nicely and it become loose, then simply if I touch it, it'll come away. That choice is yours. I said if it's become really thin, very easy, it'll come off. Now if you remove this cover, still there is a nut. Only thing is, it cannot sprout anymore. Once you remove this such a fragile, papery thin cover, if you remove, after that it becomes incapable of sprouting. Because it's a dicotyledon and it becomes two, and after that it cannot sprout. The fundamental mechanics of re-sprouting is taken away simply because this thin layer was peeled. I said, if you sit with me for a moment, this doesn't mean you just came and sat here and left. It means you really, maybe sit was not the word, if you be with me, maybe I should have said. I believed if you're here, you're with me, because I am like that. I am not… when I am here with you, I am here with you, I am no other way. I believed you're also like that and I said if you sit with me, then you come and sit there like this, okay, I sat, what happened? What can I do? So, anyway, I am not going back on my word, if you really sat with me, be… if you were being with me for a moment, it's a mechanism that naturally the peel will come off. Whether it'll come off effortlessly or little painfully, that depends on you, but it'll come off. But the nut is still there, cannot sprout, but hangs around. This is the promise we made, that we will see you don't sprout back again. But 2 days ago when we were talking about totally dissolving something. For dissolution, without some cooperation, no. Preventing you from sprouting back again, so that no more nuts come out of you. Well, I promise you I'll stick to the promise. But I thought we will raise your aspiration, instead of just not sprouting, you are able to… when you're freshly dead, we were talking about post-death only, right? Yes, the other day? Okay. When you're alive, if you do it, it's most fantastic, but you could not… you worked on it, became loose, but still could not. So you are freshly dead. Maybe that's the wrong terminology, but I like to use it. Freshly born, freshly dead. So, when you're freshly dead, at that time, to completely dissolve is a good possibility. So whether you will let me do that, or just take away the peel so that you cannot sprout and take your own time to dissolve, but cannot take on one more body. That I promised you, I will stick to that. Now I was upping my promise. I am upgrading my promise, not taking away the promise, I am upgrading the promise, not just not sprouting. Dissolution itself can be done, if only you are in a mode of cooperation. You think being like a rock like this and you want to dissolve. How to dissolve a rock? It'll take 1,000,000 years. Not that a rock cannot be dissolved, it will take 1,000,000 years. But if you become sweet like sugar or at least like salt, within minutes we can dissolve you. That's all I was saying, not going back on the promise. This is so, what will make you work or strive little more with stronger intent, so that you can also reduce the labor for your guru? This also you must think. Hello? This also you must think, not only about how you will get liberated, you must also think, how can I reduce the work for my guru? Such a thought never occurred to you? So if that is the way you are, then there are ways to hasten your sadhana. This happened. A Jewish boy, 12-year-old boy, was studying in a school. He was doing great with all the subjects, but only in mathematics he was not doing very well. Jewish families are like this. One subject not doing well is not okay. Others would say, wow, he's doing great in everything else. Math he doesn't like, it's all right. That's not how Indian families and Jewish families work. If you get 98, Indian mother will ask you, where is the other 2%? What happened? Anybody else, they will throw a party and celebrate, my son got 98%. Not in India. They will ask you, where is the other 2%? Because we come from cultures where human striving is of the highest value. Not 98%, 99%. Are you striving or not? So they decided, though they are a Jewish family, they decided to move him to a Catholic school where the math teacher was supposed to be good. So the boy went there, and after 4 months, the boy is 100 out of 100 in every test. Then the parents were so happy. Then they thought they should give a gift to the math teacher. Then they said, we want to come and meet your math teacher. He's really done miracle for you. You're getting 100 out of 100 in mathematics, which you were not able to do for the last 1.5 years in the other school. The boy said, it's got nothing to do with the math teacher. Then, how is it happening? They said, well, I saw a guy in the school who's been nailed to a plus mark. Ah! So that's it. We can do something like that for you. One of these guys will nail him or hang him upside down. See these snakes? Like this, if we do to one of you, others will strive. If that's the only way you get it, what can I do? I believe in doing things the way it works.
Next question is from Richa. Can a disciple have two masters? In case one is initiated by two spiritual masters, is it advised to stick to one way and one master, or practice what is taught by both of them? If I follow one master, then does it mean that I am being disrespectful to the other one who chose to initiate me on the path?
Well, being with a guru or a spiritual master is not a question of loyalty, but it's a question of integrity. What is the difference between loyalty and integrity? Loyalty is coming from certain emotions that you have. Integrity means that you are dedicated to the purpose for which you are there, any place. You are in some place, what is the purpose of that place? You are absolutely dedicated to that, you will not do something else there. This is happening to lot of you. You came here really to do spiritual sadhana, but you're falling in love with somebody, getting married and all this happening. Something will happen. Either you'll get headache or you'll get backache or you will get a worm in your head or your heart pulsates like that. So many things will happen, life. You don't understand that deviating from what is the purpose for which you are there is just a question of lack of integrity. Does it mean to say I should not do any of these things? Well, you must make a conscious decision, that's why you have come, to build a life around a spiritual center. It's okay with me. I'm not expecting everybody totally on fire. But you came here with fire and then compromised. That's a little bit of adjusting integrity. Loyalty is a different thing. Loyalty is not needed in this affair. So, whoever you are, if you are here and you've gone somewhere and you're struggling, please don't struggle, just dump me. And wherever you are, just do that. Because the very fact you've gone somewhere is in some way, for whatever reason, it did not work here. So you've gone somewhere, at least there you do well as long as you grow, what's my problem? Or if you were somewhere and now you're here and you're struggling here, dump the nonsense that you carried from elsewhere and do what you're required to do here. Because this is like, you know, there are coconut gardens and mango gardens. You don't go into a coconut grove, take one of these trees and plant it on top of the mountain. It won't last for a month. That's not where it works. It can only work here. Nor will you take a mango tree and plant it in a desert. Not going to work. So the very fact you moved from one place to other, either by your own choice or some other compulsion, or maybe that master is dead or I'm dead, when it happens, well, once you find the need to go somewhere, give yourself absolutely there, wherever that is. Because you can't be in this place and dig in that place, it doesn't work like that. Does it mean you're disrespectful to somebody? No. See, it's like this. You have a mother. She took care of you well, you loved her immensely. Well, for some reason she passed on. Now your aunt has come, or maybe your wife, or maybe your neighbor, or maybe somebody else. Let's say your aunt, because other things will evoke emotions which are not… we cannot settle within this question. Now your aunt is taking care of you, but you love your mother. But you must eat the food that your aunt serves. You cannot eat the food that your mother serves. It doesn't matter how much you cherish her, how much you love her. You can love her, respect her, everything, but you must eat your aunt's food. Otherwise, you will not be nourished. As simple as that. So if you've gone from here somewhere else, long distance, it's very easy to love me. Yes, yeah, very easy to love me long distance. Close up, it's big trouble. You can sit there and love me and have regard and respect for me so that your conscience will be settled. Because I want it settled quickly, because this is not a very long life, it's a brief life. Handling all this rubbish, when will you get there? Settle it quickly, I have no issue. You can love me or hate me, both ways I have no issue, but settle it somehow and focus on what you need to do. But if you've come from elsewhere to here, the same thing goes. You can have as much love and respect for anybody you want. I would say have that for just about everybody in the world. I've been telling you, if you walk on the street, because I've seen people doing this, they'll be going like this. Suddenly somebody says, "Hey, Sadhguru, Sadhguru, Sadhguru." I say, damn it, this is not going to work for you. This is not going to work for you that if you see Sadhguru, you're like this, otherwise you're like this. This is not going to work for you. No spiritual path is going to work for you like this. In some way, you must see the same quality in everybody, man, woman, child, donkey. I'm particularly picking the donkey. Donkey, cow, dog, tree, rock. You must, if you really, well, going back to the first question, if you've really sat with him for sure, okay, then you must see that in everything. You must treat everything like it's Sadhguru. Then there's no problem. So where you are, what practice you're doing, when it comes to practices, as I said, now your mother is gone, you're in your aunt's place. You must eat the food that she serves. You can love your mother as much as you want, nobody can stop it. But you must eat and nourish yourself only from the food what your aunt serves. Don't sit there thinking your mother will serve you once again, she will not and she cannot. So do not bring such conflicts, because it's a brief life. With all these complications of emotions, where will you go? The fact that you moved somewhere, obviously something did not work for you. Wherever else you've gone, please make it work, at least there. When you were here, you were thinking how to escape. Now you're somewhere else, you're wondering, maybe I should have been here. Don't do this. Once you leave a place, wherever the hell you go, make it work there at least. Just don't give up your striving, that's all that matters. When you give up your striving, I am deeply disappointed with you. Yes, if you go away and your striving is intense, I don't care, it's okay with me. That's less trouble for me. Hello? If you are deeply striving and you go away, good for me? If you give up your striving, this is wasted life for you, wasted effort for me. Don't do that. This happened. A boy came home from school and said, "Dad, do you remember? You told me if I pass my math tests, you will give me $50. The father looked up from the magazine that he was reading and said, "Yes, I remember, son." "Well, father, I have saved you the expense." Already life is invested. Now don't try to save my life. The moment you sat here, we invested, I invested my life into you in some way. Now don't try to save it. If I wanted to save it, I would have saved it myself. It's already spent. Don't try to save the money that's already spent. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry. Yoga, yoga, yogeshwaraya kala bhuta bhuta bhuteshwaraya kala kala kaleshwaraya Shiva, Shiva, Sarveshwaraya Shambha, Shambha, Mahāyā